Today, we will be recreating the Battle of New Market, which occurred on May 15th, 1864. Now, I'm going to run through the order of battle really quick. Over here, we have the 1st West Virginia Infantry. To its right is the 123rd Ohio. And to its right, we have the 18th Connecticut. Now behind them, in the rear, we have the 34th Massachusetts. And to its left, we have, in the first row, 14th Pennsylvania and 12th New York Cavalry. Behind, followed by the 1st Maryland and the 1st New York Cavalry. And to its rear, we have the 22nd Pennsylvania, the 20th Pennsylvania, and the 15th New York Cavalry. And we have our artillery batteries positioned as they were on the day of the battle. Now, to note the historical inaccuracies, as we're using the Total War engine, this battle was fought in between two creeks, the fork of the Shenandoah River and Smith Creek. So imagine on the left, if you will, the Shenandoah River arcing like so, and Smith Creek, which also arcs like so in this direction. Now, another thing to add is the Confederates, when they attacked in a line formation under the command of Wharton. And behind that line, they had the Virginia Military Institute cadets. And I've included that unique, unique unit into the gameplay, but unfortunately, since I'm playing the single player and I don't have anyone to do this with, the Confederates are just going to be attacking willy-nillys. But hopefully, they'll stick to the script, so to speak, and give you a good idea of the Battle of New Market. I will be falling back, as the Union troops did on that day. So, for my part, the Union troops will be authentic. And the reason I pick them versus the Confederates is so that I can control more of the battle by taking on the role of the army that has the most tactics, moving around on the map, that kind of stuff. More complicated, I can get a little bit of a better picture of the battle, but I've been talking too much. So, without further ado, let's get straight into the Battle of New Market, Virginia.